Hi, I am Era, and welcome to my podcast. This is the first episode of my I Love You series, excerpts from the book of Gordon O. Martin Burroughs. Love. What is it? What is love? I saw a humorous definition which said, love is a heterogeneous conglomeration of absurdity, calculated to bamboozle the anatomy of the individual who becomes intoxicated with its abominable and irresistible power. Could that ever be love? Here is another one. Love is a feeling you feel when you feel that you're going to get a feeling that you never felt before. Whatever that is, it surely isn't love. The Romans had a pantheon of gods. Jupiter, god of heavens, Bacchus, god of wine, Diana, goddess of the moon, Neptune, god of the sea, Mars, god of war, Minerva, goddess of wisdom, and their god of love was Cupid. This chubby, blindfolded boy had wings and flew with bow and arrows. Whenever Cupid shot with a gold-tipped arrow, his victim fell blindly in love with the first person encountered. Could that be true love? Do you know that the shortest and most profound statement on love is found in the Bible? Just three words. God is love. It's from 1 John chapter 4, verse 8. No, not that kind of love, someone objects. Tell me about romantic love, the hugging and the kissing love. That is the love we are talking about. All true love, parent for child, husband for wife, girlfriend for boyfriend. All true love comes from God. That tender emotion, that ability to desire, that capacity to caress was implanted in our being by the Creator, God. He is the source of love. And if love comes from God, it can be comfortable in the presence of God. But for every good thing that God has made, the devil has improvised a counterfeit. Love's counterfeit is infatuation. The big question is, how can one discern the counterfeit from the genuine? Let us examine some differences. Infatuation or love. Infatuation is ruled by feelings, but love's feelings are ruled by principle. In the field of infatuation, the feelings are in charge. But the problem is that our feelings are fickle. They change easily. Today I feel great, so I kiss her. Tomorrow I feel terrible, so I kick her. That's not love. True love has feelings, tender feelings, which are put in the human heart by a caring God. But love is not composed of feelings only. It is feeling plus principle. Moreover, love is not controlled by feelings. It does not do anything and everything it feels. Rather, in true love, the feelings are under the control of principle. One of the grandest descriptions of love is found in Scripture. Here it is. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud, it is not rude, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered, it keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. It's from the 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verses 4 to 7. Then comes the profound statement, love never fails. Infatuation is blind, but love sees and examines. Like Cupid, infatuation is blind. It cannot see and does not wish to see. When a girl recognizes that her boyfriend is hooked on drugs, but still proceeds with plans for marriage, Cupid has wounded her. When a boy observes his girlfriend flirting continuously with other men, but still goes ahead with a love affair, infatuation has blinded him. Jesus asked, "Do you have eyes but fail to see?" It's on Mark chapter 8, verse 18. True love uses its eyes to see and to examine the strengths and weaknesses of the prospective partner. It is not afraid to ask hard questions, nor to do difficult examinations. Infatuation is in a hurry, but love takes time. Everything of permanent value in life takes time. We can build a shack overnight, but if we are building a house that will stand the fury of a hurricane, that takes time. We can put up an artificial Christmas tree overnight, but to grow a real tree, that takes time. It has to be planted, watered, and nourished for weeks, months, or years. Love is a plant, a tender, precious plant. Infatuation is ever in a hurry. See her today, court her tomorrow, and marry her the day after. It's love at first sight. It's puppy love. And someone has rightly said, puppy love leads to a dog's life. But while this puppy love is in a hurry, true love takes time. Time to know and time to grow. Knowing a person always takes time, and there is no shortcut. Growing a relationship takes time, and God expects couples in love to grow up. It's from Ephesians chapter 4, verse 15. Thank you for listening. I hope you will listen again to the next episode of my I Love You series. Stay safe and happy, everyone.